Good evening and welcome to Poland Daily. I'm Konrad Gorlinski. Well, the regime of the Belarusian dictator, Alexander Lukashenko, is attacking Poland, Lithuania, and Latvia with illegal immigrants. Dozens of people are camping on the Polish-Belarusian border, while the opposition media in Poland are trying to force the government to give in to the demands of the Belarusian services and open the borders. Deputy Foreign Affairs Minister Paweł Jabłoński accused the largest TV network of playing in tune with Moscow propaganda outlets. The liberal media has been at war with the ruling Law and Justice Party practically since the October 2015 elections. So far, however, they have avoided using the tricks of Moscow propaganda, which uses immigrants from Iraq and Syria. According to Polish intelligence, these people bought a trip to Belarus and paid the regime in Minsk to cross the EU border. Their goal is refugee status in rich Western countries. Meanwhile, Belarusian television presents them as refugees from Afghanistan, to whom Poland refused humanitarian aid. The aim of the action is to cause divisions between NATO countries and the European Union. During an interview with TV and television, the Deputy Foreign Minister Paweł Jabłoński presented footage from the station's news service, which not only quoted material from Belarusian television, but also omitted the most important facts about the pressure of immigrants on the Polish border. I'm ashamed that there are journalists in Poland who support Alexander Lukashenko. If you're ashamed, why do you come to us? So that your viewers can know the facts as they really are, and not what you have been consistently presenting for several days, repeating information from the Belarusian services. We are dealing with manipulated propaganda, which you can see almost one-to-one. And this is the same message that is in the Belarusian media. This is in Russia today. Opposition media oppose the blockade of a group of migrants on the border with Poland and demand that Polish officers cross into Belarus and provide the migrants with water, food, and medicine. Moreover, opposition activists and celebrities appear near the border as a popularity stunt, and they demand disclosure of data from the Polish officers and soldiers. Finally, the opposition-linked TV station TVN24 broadcasts almost all these events live. Meanwhile, Polish soldiers are building a razor wire fence on the border with Belarus as the government tries to stem the flow of migrants crossing its frontier. Poland announced earlier this week it would construct a 2.5 meter, 8.2 foot high solid fence on the border and double the number of troops there. The European Union, unlike in 2015, supports a tough stance against illegal immigrants. What is happening between the borders of Poland and Belarus is not a question of migration, but part of Lukashenko's aggression against Poland, Lithuania, and Latvia in order to destabilize the European Union. Lithuania proposed the European Union sanctions Belarusian citizens and companies which it says are helping migrants cross into the EU member states. And the Lithuanian government has already sent a list of Belarusian citizens and companies it holds responsible for the increased migrant arrivals to the EU's External Action Service. Sorry, jeszcze raz to ostatnie, bo mnie... Lithuania proposed the European Union sanctions Belarusian citizens and companies which it says are helping migrants cross into the EU member states. And the Lithuanian government has already sent a list of Belarusian citizens and companies it holds responsible for the increased migrant arrivals to the EU's External Action Service. Only last Friday, the border guard thwarted 90 attempts to illegally cross the Polish border. However, 40 people were detained. Since the beginning of August, the border guard recorded 3,200 illegal attempts to cross the border. At the military airport in Warsaw, the last two Hercules military planes have landed, carrying Polish soldiers returning from their mission in Afghanistan. Minister of National Defense Mariusz Błaszczak greeted them on the tarmac.
I thank each of you individually for the mission you performed in an exemplary manner in Afghanistan, said Błaszczak. You undertook a demanding mission, but, well, these kinds of missions are not easy, but you have already been on many such difficult missions. You are well-trained, you have the right attitude, high morale. You serve Poland because this service is service to Poland. In this way, we take care of the security of our homeland far beyond the borders of our country. Polish Air Force aircraft operated from Kabul to Uzbekistan, and then approximately 1,000 evacuees switched to civilian LOT Polish Airlines airplanes. President Andrzej Duda authorized the use of Polish armed forces in this operation. After landing in Rome, the NATO senior civilian representative to Afghanistan said that staff involved in efforts to evacuate as many people from Kabul as possible did its best under the difficult circumstances it had to face.
With a clean conscience for myself and my team, but unsatisfied. Clean conscience because with what we had, we did our best under the circumstances. And I think we crossed the line between possible and impossible to get in everybody we could, to keep the airport running, to coordinate whatever was coordinatable in that situation. Unsatisfied because we have left a few behind, which we are not abandoning, but which we will strive our best to take back home.
Italy's military has airlifted over 4,800 Afghans out of the country, including 1,453 children, the defense ministry has said, as part of an international evacuation effort after the Taliban unexpectedly seized control of the capital earlier this month.
75 years ago today, the communists murdered almost 18-year-old Danuta Shijikovna, a.k.a. Inka, a nurse in the 5th Vilnius Brigade of the Home Army. She was shot dead on the morning of August 28, 1946. Inka, together with wartime commander Lieutenant Felix Selmanovich, a.k.a. Zagonchik. They're one of thousands of freedom fighters who objected to the takeover of Poland by the Soviet communists. If caught by the communist police, Polish heroes were brutally tortured and Stalinist courts had them executed and bodies were disposed of. Inka and Zagonchik's remains were found only in 2014. Only then did they receive a proper burial. Polish youth can now learn the last words Inka wrote from prison. Tell Grandma that I did what was proper. Well, thank you for tuning in this evening. I hope you have a wonderful Saturday night.